I'm Elio Manzi.
I'm Matt Qualben.
I'm Dan Levesque.
I'm Captain Patel.
We are here today to discuss our suspension idea for the 2014 Mini Baja competition. The first thing that needs to be taken into consideration when we decided to make our design was the four types of races that our car must go through. These four races are rock crawl, hill climb, acceleration, and maneuverability. In the rock crawl and hill climb, the biggest thing that is tested is the traction of our car. And the acceleration and maneuverability test, it is testing our vehicle's ability to shift its weight from forward to back and side to side. Next, in deciding what our suspension was going to be, we decided that outside factors and forces on our car must be taken into consideration, which are rocks, terrain, and any types of jumps and or bumps our car will go through in this race. Next, we tried to cover cost effectiveness, durability, sustainability, and ease of adjustment, because one of the biggest things in this race is for you to be able to adjust your car to the types of races it's going through with ease and quickness.
So one of the first things that we talked about was what the previous teams have used in terms of their suspension systems. What our team here at URI has been using is a double wishbone suspension system. This is an example of an independent suspension system. It consists of an upper and lower control arm. These two control arms can either be shaped like an A, like an L, or just two straight links. Mounts from the chassis to the wheel. The strut and coil are then mounted onto the lower control arm in whatever shape it may be, and that goes from the lower control arm up to the chassis. That is where you'll get all of your shock absorption, and when you go over jumps and bumps, that's how your car is going to keep a smooth ride. One of the big advantages to a double wishbone suspension system is the ease for adjustment in terms of your camber, dive resistance, and other kinematics of the shocks of the suspension system. One big drawback is it can be really heavy and it can be extremely costly to produce. In terms of the Mini Baja, it's not exactly the best. This suspension system is ideal for a passenger vehicle on an on-road course, not really with what the off-roading thing that we're going to be doing with this Mini Baja.
As we began researching what suspension system we would use, we started looking at other vehicles that do roughly the same thing, and we started looking at ATVs and what rear suspension system they use, and realized a lot of them use a three-point suspension system, which, as we researched more, we realized would be ideal for this application. The three-point suspension system has an easier design. It's very adaptable to all the different types of things we have to do.
So as we're indicating upon the rock crawl and the hill climb, the major point of this suspension design is easy accessibility to adjusting camber. The way we adjusted the camber is we had the two control arms, upper and lower, pretty much connected to this plate right here. And on the double A arm, you have like that. So this would be the upper, then you have another one, the lower. This would be adjusted. But on ours, we just have this one joint right here that's going to be adjusted. What that would do is you shorten this, bring this closer. That will then make this go out, or you can extend it, bring the camber like this, so you get negative or positive. In most cases, though, on the rock hill and the hill climb, you would want negative camber, so it would be going down. Has better traction. On top of this, as you can see over here, we just have the two links. So one link, two link, upper, lower, vice versa on the other side. You have the axle right here connected with the drive. Goes all the way to the drivetrain over here, so you'd have the engine on top. Everything else over here brings the entire weight down to the lower, so a lower center of gravity. And then that's the whole point of this back.
Today I'll be talking to you about the trailing arm. So just to give you a general overview, the trailing arm is going to connect the chassis to the axle, providing external strength in the suspension design. Some of the great benefits are that it is great because moving along with the jumps up and down, your trailing arm is going to be best suited more than the double wishbone. Another benefit is It's going to provide exceptional strength and rigidness to the chassis, just to prevent against deformations when it lands on jumps and things like that. However, the cons are the lack of control in suspension adjustments, such as your adjustment for camber, which is why we included the double wishbone system into it. This over here is a top view. This is going to allow us to control the toe of the vehicle. Now, during our mini Baja and during the races, we don't want any toe. We don't want positive toe nor negative toe. So the benefit of having this suspension system is if any component of the suspension system gets damaged in between races, you get easy accessibility to adjusting the toe back to zero, the toe being this movement right here. With positive and negative toe, you will be either plowing or shoveling the dirt, which is then going to reduce your acceleration and increase additional wear on the tires and other suspension system components. This over here, we have the side view of the trailing arm. The major benefit of this is, as you can see, our strut and shock are absorbed one piece onto the trailing arm, and that's going to allow for movement in the upward and downward position. This is beneficial because it's going to be absorbing the shocks and going along with the course.
The bill of materials included in this design was two A-arms, two link plates, two of these pins which control the camber, and the whole frame and the engine that was given to us in the CVT. That is our project. Thank you for listening.